no matter how wonderful it is, it's not worth an infinite price. So we have to have a price that makes sense and gives a margin of safety considering the natural vicissitudes of life. That's a very simple set of ideas. And the reason that our ideas have not spread faster is they're too simple. The professional classes can't justify their existence if that's all they have to say.
这段视频让我们聊聊芒格继续加码阿里的事件。你认为阿里现在的股价是一个绝好机会，还是认为他老糊涂，错过了一些很重要的东西呢？我们真的应该避开在美国上市的中国股票呢？你可以在下面留言，让大家知道你的想法。首先，芒格是一个价值投资者，除非有很大的安全边际，在股价和他计算的内在价值之间有一个很大的缓冲，否则他不会投资。在前几支影片，我们都说了很多关于阿里的故事，它是一家非常强大的公司，在中国经济增长的背景下非常重要。中国有14亿人口，其中12亿人可以上网，阿里在中国的活跃客户有超过9亿，所以是中国其中一家最重要的公司之一。不过在2021年的时间里，公司的股票出现了许多问题。加强监管，从纽约股市中除名，蚂蚁金融的 IPO 被停止，如此多的问题导致股价下跌超过 50%， 但这也吸引了许多大户价值投资者买阿里的股票。我们已经看到芒格、达利奥、帕布雷买了阿里，虽然他最近确实把手头上阿里的股票卖了，并将这笔钱投入腾讯，但不管怎样，阿里一直在价值投资者中非常受欢迎，尤其是芒格。随着2021年最后一个季度的结束，芒格的反应非常迅速，实际上已经发布了他的季度 13F 档案，显示他买了更多阿里。芒格是 Daily Journal 公司的董事长，负责管理资金，他对自己的股票投资组合非常谨慎。他的一个核心投资理念是不经常买卖，其实跟巴菲特差不多，所以只有在看到好机会时才会买，所以大部分时间都花在等待，平时一般做的是积累现金和等待那些黄金机会。我们可以看到他做的跟他说的是一致的。如果你看看他的公司从2013年至2020年的历史，投资组合实际上没有改变过，他一直没有买入新股，也没有卖出股票，一直显示了只有四只股票。但在2021年第一季度，芒格买了阿里，这在当时成为头条新闻，所以很多人都在讨论，特别是因为投资界真的开始对中国打击在美国上市的中国企业感到恐慌。所以芒格的这一举动让我们很吃惊，更加关注阿里和他的一举一动。但奇怪的是，在第二季度，阿里的股价继续下跌，但芒格没有任何举动，没有增加他的仓位。但当股价跌至140块钱时，他新增了 82% 的仓位。随后第四季度财报公布后，股价跌穿了支持位置，达到了52周低点，每股108块钱。老实说，因为我是用技术分析进场的，所以从技术角度分析，即便我看好阿里，也不会在这个时间进场。但因为芒格是价值投资者，所以坚持他的投资策略，继续买进，而且买进了30万股，现在总计超过60万股。现在持仓现实占他投资组合的 27%， 几乎与富国银行的仓位相同。这就是价值投资者的典型行为，价格持续下跌，他继续买入，代表着机会越来越好，在别人害怕时就贪婪，与一般人持相反态度，这是一个非常重要的特征。作为一个投资者，他有信心在价格下跌时继续买入，果断行动的信心来自于透彻理解业务，而这正是芒格在这个例子中所拥有的。你们很多人认为芒格对中国的整个经济和政治制度了解不够深入，但事实真的是这样吗？也许是你们带有偏见错过了什么。
Mr. Munger is a champion of Chinese stocks. How concerned is he about Chinese government interference as seen recently with Ant Financial, Alibaba, and Mr. Jack Ma? What, for example, is to stop the Chinese government from simply deciding one day to nationalize BYD?
Well, I consider that very unlikely. And I think Jack Ma was very arrogant to be telling the Chinese government how dumb they were and how stupid their policies were and so forth. Considering their system, that is not what he should have been doing. I think the Chinese have behaved very, very shrewdly in managing their economy, and they've gotten better results than we have in managing our economy. And I think that that will probably continue. And sure, we all love the kind of civilization we have. I'm not saying I want to live in China. I prefer the United States. But I do admire what the Chinese have done. How can you not do it? Nobody else has ever taken a big country out of poverty so fast and so long. And what I see in China now just staggers me. There are factories in China that are just absolutely full of robots and are working beautifully. They're no longer using peasant girls to beat the brains out of our little shoe companies in America.
所以芒格似乎花了时间研究中国的政治制度，也了解中国的经济制度，这使他能够迅速驳斥这些媒体报道，也给大家带来更多的信心。中国最近证实，他们不想强迫在美上市的中国股票摘牌，他们不想禁止 V 结构，他们不想摧毁中国最大的企业，这不是他们的目的。事实，当我们看得越多，就越意识到中共正在做正确的事情。他们对阿里征收了巨额反垄断罚款，因为他们滥用了垄断权力，要在淘宝卖东西的人二选一。所有的事情都是有理据的，他们所做的一切行为确实是可预测的，并非不可预测。作为一个价值投资者，能够消除所有这些负面的媒体声音至关重要。你必须进行独立研究，这取决于你对业务的了解程度。
This question's for Charlie. It comes from Stephen Tedder in Atlanta. He's been a Berkshire shareholder for 10 years and says, you and your friend Li Lu have been very optimistic with respect to investing opportunities in China. BYD has performed spectacularly for Berkshire since its initial purchase in 2008 and is currently valued at $5.8 billion. The Daily Journal recently bought a large position in Alibaba after founder Jack Ma had been reprimanded by the Chinese Communist Party and Ma's other company, Ant, was not allowed to proceed with its IPO. What are your current thoughts on China and whether the communist leaders will allow businesses with strong leadership to flourish in decades to come?
Well, I think that, that the Chinese government will allow businesses to flourish. It was one of the most remarkable things that ever happened in the history of the world. When a bunch of committed communists just looked at the prosperity of places like Singapore and said, the hell with this, we're not gonna stay here in poverty, we're gonna copy what works. And they changed communism. They just accepted Adam Smith and added it to their communism. And said, now we have communism with Chinese characteristics, which is China with a free market with a bunch of billionaires and so forth. And they made that shift. They deserve a lot of credit. Warren and I are not quite as good at that as changing our minds in many cases. Yeah. And that was a remarkable change coming from such a place. And of course, it's worked like gangbusters. It had this enormous growth in the average income of the average Chinese. They've lifted 800 million people out of poverty fast. And there's never anything like it in the history of the world. So my hat is off to the Chinese. And I think they will continue to allow people to make money. They've learned it works. The Chinese, I love what the guy said in the first place. I don't care whether the cat is black and white as long as it catches mice. That's my kind of talk.